koppie is een baie belangrike verhaal om te vertel, want ek dink, dit is baie belangrik vir ons allemaal, as Suid-Afrikaners, ek dink wereldburgers, om weer terug te kom naar die menslikheid. Om weer terug te kom, dat ons net stil word en rustig word en mekaar sy stories kan aanhoor. Maar baie meer belangrik vir my is dat ons mekaar kan hoor. Regtig kan hoor en regtig kan sien. En ek praat oor ouderdomsgrense heen, weet, geslagsgrense heen, kleergrense heen. Ons wil onsself verstout om te sê, ons is lekker los en vry vandag. Maar ek dink vir almal van ons wat in Poppie gewerk het, dat so bietjie moes teruggaan na die 70er jare en na die Suid-Afrikaanse samelewing van daai tyd kyk en daarin die story vertel. Jy besef, ons het aangeskuif, maar ook nog nie baie en nie genoeg nie. En vir my net baie belangrik, ek is baie lief daarvoor dat Christiaan ons fokus op Poppie se verhaal en die menslikheid wat daarmee saamkom.
Poppie is a very important story to tell for South African women, irrespective of color or creed. Because it is a battle of a woman that is fighting her individual battles and traveling her individual journey. Irrespective of that, she was faced with this giant of a government, of a regime. But she still managed to stand. She still managed to stand for what she believed in. So for me and for our country, it's for us to look back and see what other women went through. Are our challenges more than Poppy's challenges? Are we much better than Poppy? Because I believe that what Poppy did, she fought a battle that has put some of us where we are today.
I think Poppy Nongena's story is important because a lot of people in modern South Africa can relate with those type of characters. I remember I had my mom was a umweseli, you know, and they used to go to church, take care of their family, put family above all things. Marriage was important. So there's so many values that the character of Poppy Nongena carries, you know, raising a son that's almost becoming rebellious, that's almost feeling like, no, you know what, there's a cause that I want to fight for. And Poppy's saying, no, you belong in this family. You need to do right for this family. So there's so many, there's so much depth in this character that I believe the women of today, the young women of today, can really take away from this character.
Ek dink Poppy is 'n belangrike verhaal om te vertel, want ek dink te veel van ons loop met oogklappe rond en is dit ons daai oogklappe afhaal en ons medemens begin raak sien.
Honestly, I think Poppy is a very important story to tell because there are people who like have undergone very traumatic and very painful you know, survivals of apartheid in not only Cape Town, like the whole of South Africa. And I do believe that, you know, there are some people going through that, but it's just the repercussions of what had happened before. So it is important for them to see that everything that has happened, we can still move on. I mean, we're standing here because of a woman named Poppy who was able to, you know, fight for her children, fight for her life, stay in Cape Town, even though the vet said it's not allowed, you're not allowed to stay here. And I think it's a very, very important story to tell because of that, yeah.
I think it's one of the belangrijkste boeken wat geschreven is in Afrikaans. Ek dink dit is die eerste keer dat mense regtig bewus was about the other half lives. Ek dink dit is ook relevant vir vandag. Ek dink daar is oral die wêreld oor is daar 'n migration crisis. Ons weet nie wat om met mense te doen wat nie 'n heenkome het nie, wat uit oorlogsones ontsnap en dan word hulle soos 'n Poppy gesê, hulle mag nie meer in die stad bly waar hulle 'n lewe het, 'n huis het, 'n kinders het. Ek dink die fliek is relevant op internasionale vlak ook.
Firstly, it's based on a true story and it happened in Cape Town. Exactly where the books, the novel says it happened, that's where it happened. Poppy stayed or lived in Yanga. And secondly, for one to see such an amazing story done for the first time by South Africans. The whole cast is South African, the crew is South African, the director is South African. That makes it very, very powerful, doing our own work for ourselves, so that the whole world can see what we are capable of doing.
Well, I think almal moet dit sien. Elke liewe Suid-Afrikaner moet dit sien. Man, vrou, kinders, almal kan dit sien. Dit is 'n Suid-Afrikaanse story. En jy weet, Elsa Joubert is gebaseer op haar boek. Maar so die tekst wat Saartjie Botha en Christian by mekaar gesit het, natuurlijk ontleen daarvan. So dis die basis. En Elsa Joubert het een wye kop, so wyd soos die Heer se genade, maar sy het een ongelooflike ding om die mens te verstaan, om my empathie te hê. So ek dink die film is ook vir enige iemand om te kyk. En ek hoop regtig waar, elke liewe Suid-Afrikaner.
I think every type of audience, every kind of audience, this is history. This is South Africa. This woman is an icon. She is a woman of valor, a woman that knew that whatever she was doing, she knew there's a wall she's facing. But she told herself, with the little hammer that I have, I'm going to break through that wall.
To be honest, if you're South African, you need to see the movie. Everybody else, they should see the movie too. However, I do think if you are South African, you need to see the movie, understand what people have gone through, understand what people are going through, understand how the struggle was in the country, the youth especially, because we are now living as though it never happened, as though everything is okay again, whereas it's not really okay. We're working towards it, but we're trying. We're really trying. Yeah.
I think it's a family film. Why I say it's a family film, because it does not separate black or white, young and old. It caters to the family picture. So if you believe that you come from a family and you as your family have been through some things, have tackled some challenges, have seen, different values, whether in church, outside of church, in school and things like that, it's a family film that incorporates everyone, because it's got a bit of something for everyone, even us as the kids. I know I'm a bit older, I play a young kid in the film, and I think even young children be able to relate with my character, because I'm that kid that's so hopeful, that's full of life, that ensures that the family, even though they're under stress and duress, but I bring that life within the story. So yeah,
almal in Suid-Afrika moet dit kyk, almal. Ek dink die boek het my verander om die fliek te maak in my verander, en ek dink mense wat dit sien, dit gaan jou verander.
I had a very wonderful experience. There was unity, there was love, there was togetherness. We were working together, we had a very brilliant director, we had a very brilliant cast, we had a very brilliant crew. Even the background artists, they were the best we could ever have looked for.
Ek het dit rare geniet om te werk op die stel. Specifiek omdat hierdie keer was die kinematograaf vrou, en daar was 'n ander type energie opstel, en ek het dit baie geniet, en behalwe daarvoor, die acteurs saam met wie ons gewerk het, was net fenomenaal, en was my so lekker om te sit en te kyk hoe die meesterlike performances voor my afspeel.
Man, we had a wonderful, wonderful director, Christian Orbach. We had a beautiful cast ensemble with us. I think everyone knew what they had to do. And Christian's method of directing also, it was very theatric, like stage. So it didn't feel like, oh, there's a drill sergeant, do this, do that in front of the camera. But it was very playful. We rehearsed a lot. And I think we also built such a wonderful chemistry coming together as the actors. Because even before we acted, we sort of had a table read. We did a lot of rehearsals together. By the time we actually got on set, we had built that chemistry together, so yeah.
Ach, dit is absoluut heerlik. Dit is altijd vir my, om met Christian te werk is my lekker, omdat hy op story focus. Dit is belangriker dan allemaal van ons. Dit is vir my lekker, op die waarheid focus van wat is bezig om te doen. En dan was het net Clementine Mosamani, Poppy, die hele fliek, dis Clementine, en haar vertolking, en om deel daarvan te kon wees, het was net magisch om saam met haar opstel te wees, en saam met haar te werk. Dis het soos een sistergevoel. Ek het een keer gesê, in een stadium het ek geweet, waar ek op, en waar begin sy, en waar begin sy, en waar ek op. Nee, het was net heerlijk om een medespeler te hê, die paar tonele wat ons saam gehad het, wat het net toe oor vertrouwe.
It was beautiful, actually. You know, working with this whole cast and the crew, to be honest with you, in this particular movie, it wasn't a situation whereby one sees himself as a lead or a secondary lead. Or you look at the others and say, these are extras. Everybody had an input, a major, major input.
I had a blast, I won't even lie. It was a great time. Clementine, oh my gosh, so loving. a real Poppy. She's so loving, so beautiful. She's given me words of encouragement. Christian, amazing director. He, oh my goodness, he's perfectionist. He gets everything he wants, how he wants it, and I admire his work. If I were to be a director, I think I'm looking forward to being like that guy. I think we had a real family dynamic, and I enjoyed being with all of those people because I think we brought the story to life with our lives into their story. So yeah.
Ek was so bevoorreg om die ongelooflikste. Ek dink, ek weet nie, daar's 'n belaglike getal, maar daar's iets soos amper 60 pratende, sprekende rolle in die film. En elke persoon, van 'n ekstra tot 'n ander maar tot Clementine Mosimane, almal het hulle alles gegee. En hulle self regtig ingeleef, bloed, sweet en trane. En ek weet dis 'n klisjé, maar dis regtig wat mense gedoen het. Ek was so bevoorreg, nie net met die akteurs nie, maar die hele span. En ek dink the proof is in the pudding.